again, and welcome to episode 3 of our playthrough of Coral Island. So, spring, day 5, Friday. Oh, Mark. Yes, good morning, I'm Mark. You're the new farmer. I know. I'm here to give you some info. The cavern, northwest of here, is now open right through the forest. When you see Jack's ranch, go left and follow the path. It's closed. You lost me. Find the ranch and go left. There should be a sign to lead you. Catch any of that? A band of smiles cleared up the top level of the caverns. It's safe to roam, no monsters anymore. Just don't go too deep. Your garden rake won't help you there. That's all. If you want to know more, ask Kira. I'm done here. Grumpy. Waste of time. Yay! Harvest! Ta-da! 15 turnips and 1 daisy. Open your journal to claim your reward. Ta-da! Crafting kiln. So we unlocked the kiln last episode. Bronze and stone. This process is wood into charcoal, scrap into glass and stone, and stone into glass. Okay. Mastery, foraging, 1 available point. So, increases selling price of all foraged goods. Yep. And I can earn more money. Water the plants. I've got water. Daisy won't tell me so. What am I? 41. 4, 5, 6, 7. So 35. So I get 20 profit from that. Sell one of those. 35 as well. So I get the same profit from those. So I'll sell all you. And we bought a bunch of potatoes. Carrots are 7 days. Cauliflower are 10 days. So we'll buy 2, 3, 4, 5 cauliflower and get the rest carrot seeds. Potatoes already. Let's hope they give me a sword. Right, so, up to the ranch, turn left, follow the path to the caverns. What's that? Wasabi. Looking farmer, get back. Get back from the Wait a minute. Where are the monsters? Well, Mark and I did clear out the top levels. But that quake. The shaking happened right after you entered, right? About certain curses reacting to a presence, but that can wait. My name is Kira. Assume you're the new farmer. Being a farmer and all, you're probably here to do some mining. In that case, only the earth shaft is currently accessible. The elevator over there works, but only down to the first floor. From there, you'll have to descend by foot. If you go down deep enough, you can restore access to the other floors. You've definitely come to the right place to mine for ores and gems. These caves have them aplenty. Just don't forget they have monsters too. Take this sword. You'll need something to defend yourself with. It's a long descent, so make sure you're well supplied. Be careful down there, and good luck. 5. Turn the elevator back on. Okay. Level 1. Let's go in the inventory. Switch up order. I didn't bring my pickaxe. Came to the mine and didn't bring my pickaxe. Run as fast as you can. Well, that was fun. Let's try again. These forageables. Shall see. It's a bit loud. Actually apply that. Let's try again. It's a bit better. Wait a little bit. Good. Compost. Do all the little stones first. Jellyfish from Finding Nemo. The pink jellyfish. It's new either way. And then just a pink blob. go. Time is it 5 o'clock? We might make it. It's a miner's skull that's staggered. Oh, that's new as well. What's that? Cursed fragment. A monster looks cursed. Very easy enough. Monster essence. Is it their insides or their soul? No. Shift scarecrow. Okay. Level up mining. Explosive. Corrigibles. Canola. Wasabi. Mining. We all sell for 10. It's not worth selling. Unlocked. Journal to claim reward. Wood. Oh! Can craft them straight out of the boxes. Fabulous. Makes it so much easier. 5x5. I think I'm gonna need 2 of those. Mastery. So I have no points. The first one doesn't give you any points. Oh! Pablo, hello, hello. What could be better than a visit from your local blacksmith? Word around town is that you've started to mine the earth shaft. That's actually why I'm here. As you mine, you'll come across ores. What good does that do to me? Do me, you might be thinking. Well, you can turn ores into bars. With enough bars, our shop can upgrade your tools. Work smarter, not harder, as I like to say. For a fee, of course. To make bars, you'll need a furnace, which you now can craft, courtesy of this blueprint. Thank you very much. You need 5 of the same ores to make 1 bar. You'll also need 1 charcoal to fire up the furnace. Yep, I think you're all set now. Thank you. Craft a furnace. Okay. Crafting. So I still don't have enough bars. So that's the kiln. So it's not that. No. Whoa! There was a lot of crows. right. Let's stick you here. And you here. And then let's pick these up. Oh. Lettuce potato. Sell those. Let's craft another scarecrow. I can't put it there. It'll just have to. The crows give you seeds. Well, one seed. Better than nothing. And realistic, of course. So that we can craft some ore. Craft some ore. Craft some bars. And craft a furnace. There's a mushroom. Blob 1 and blob 2, probably. What is that? It's a golem. Don't like those, the chests, though. You find the tree seeds in. Goop. partner. From Scooby-Doo, Mysterious Island. That's what they look like. around here. Let's head back up. Need to go bug catching in the dark. Transformers, are you going there? You go in there. Sell mushrooms. Craft a furnace. Oh, I've got enough. Two seeds, we'll plant these two seeds. Do we wait? Do we not? No. I don't think we need to wait. Level up mining, rope and a stone sign. Farming, there we go. So. Lettuce. Oh, that comes from the wild seeds. It's not cauliflower, it's lettuce. Okay. So that's full profit then. 42. 66 for a potato. Potatoes are worth 35. It's about 30. 30 profit. But not quite double. Okay. Well, thank you everyone for watching episode 3 of our playthrough. Please leave a like and a comment on what you liked, what you didn't like, and I'll see you next time.